today, we're going to be diving into a trending topic, one that may reshape how we work and succeed. A recent study found frequent AI tool users showed weaker critical thinking abilities due to cognitive offloading. Essentially, what that means is you're outsourcing your thoughts and your thinking to AI. Made for you, come feel the tide. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Made human, feel the glow from the city to the fields. Watch it grow, watch it grow. Bomb, bomb beats, heart sink and flow in the flow. Tech innovation, here we go, here we go, here we go. Hey everyone, welcome to Tech Innovation Made Human, brought to you by the Tech Simplified Network. I'm Jeremy McKellar, your host, and today we're going to be diving into a trending topic, one that may reshape how we work and succeed. I've been doing a lot of studying recently. One article that did pique my interest that just came out hot off the press from a tech futurist, Sinead Bovell, recently highlighted something profound. AI is coming for the unmotivated. Okay, let that sit in for a little bit. AI might be creating a widening gap between those who use it strategically and those who use it as a replacement for thinking. But is this really happening? All right, so we're going to take some time to dive into this. What are other tech leaders saying? And most importantly, what does it mean for your career and business? So let's dive on in. And as always, before we get started, the opinions and insights expressed in this video are my own and of those of Tech Simplified. These are our personal views based off of research, based off of our own understandings, and do not represent the positions of any employer, organization, or company that we may be affiliated with. Okay, now that we got all of that out the way, let's dive into this new feature spotlight, vibe coding. So if you, unless you live underneath a rock, you may have heard of vibe coding, or maybe you haven't. It is a term that's taken the tech world, the AI space, every single facet of industry is taking it by storm. This trend, it emerged when OpenAI co-founder Andres Karpathy described a new coding approach where developers give in to the vibes, right? And they let AI handle most of the actual coding. What made this more than just internet chatter was when Y Combinator, they revealed in an article that a quarter of their current startup batch have 95% of their code bases generated by AI. But here's what's fascinating about this. These aren't inexperienced people. These are highly skilled founders who know exactly what they're doing. The AI isn't replacing their expertise, it's amplifying it. This pattern isn't limited to coding. We're seeing it across industries from marketing to finance, from design to education. There's a lot of other applications to where vibe coding and vibe marketing and the overall vibing experience is happening in our world. So we're going to dive into those. People with strong foundations are using AI to soar higher while others risk falling behind. I know that we've talked about that on previous episodes. We went through discussing how to make your own Pixar image. We talked about how AI is catching up to us as humans. Definitely make sure you check back on some of those episodes as well. But quickly, let's look at how this works in practice, okay? How does vibe coding work in practice? Just as a pure example of some of the capabilities of how AI is amplifying what you can do on a day-to-day basis. Tools like GitHub Copilot, Cursor, and Windsurf have transformed coding. You describe what you want to build and the AI generates most of the code for you. I want to say two episodes back, we talked about Google's Firebase that they released where you can describe the application that you're looking to create and it'll make it for you, or at least make a prototype for you. That's one instance of vibe coding. But here's the crucial insight. The quality of what you get depends heavily on how you direct the AI. AI doesn't just follow your instructions. It amplifies your intent. Vague directions get mediocre results. Precise guidance gets exceptional outcomes. Patrick Ellis, CTO at Seattle startup Snapbar, noted that AI coding tools made them so much more productive that they decided to hold off on hiring an engineer they had planned to bring on. But this efficiency comes with a potential cost. A recent study found frequent AI tool users showed weaker critical thinking abilities due to cognitive offloading. Essentially, what that means is you're outsourcing your thoughts and your thinking to AI, as opposed to using your own critical thought processes and then providing that to AI. You don't want AI to just be completely in the driver's seat, so to speak. You want it to be passenger with you, but you're still driving, okay? This leads us to our core questions. How are leaders navigating this new landscape, and what impact will it have on our future, okay? So diving into the tech leadership insights, tech leaders are divided on whether AI's motivational gap is a feature or a bug. Salesforce CEO Marc Benioff has been outspoken about AI creating a productivity divide between companies. AI isn't just creating a new economy. It's creating two different economies running at two different speeds. NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang takes a different view. He believes AI will eventually become an equalizer. AI will be like electricity, something everyone has access to. The question is, who will be most creative in how they use it? This brings me to my first original insight. AI doesn't care about your credentials or your experience. It cares about the quality of your thoughts and of your thinking. It's the first technology that rewards clarity of thought above all else. Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella has highlighted this mental shift required for AI success. It's not about knowing all the answers. It's about knowing which questions to ask. And I think that has been the theme for everyone across their career. You got to know the right questions to ask to get to where you want to get to. I've observed this firsthand in working with various teams. Those who approach AI with a clear understanding of their goals consistently outperform those who expect AI to provide the goals for them. LinkedIn co-founder Reid Hoffman framed it perfectly. AI is becoming a thought partner, not just a tool. And like any partnership, both sides need to bring something valuable. This leads to my second original thought. The real AI divide isn't between those who use AI and those who don't. It's between those who use AI as a thought multiplier and those who use it as a thought replacement. GitLab CEO recently noted that their most productive developers weren't those using AI the most. They were those using AI most strategically. It's not about offloading work. It's about offloading the right work. This strategic approach is what separates companies that are transforming with AI from those merely adopting it. So what does the impact of all of this mean, right? And mean for our future? First, we're already seeing businesses separate into two tiers. Microsoft Research with IDC found companies get an average of $3.70 in return for every dollar invested in AI. But that return varies dramatically based on implementation quality. Based on analysis of current trends, here are three major impacts that we may see in the future. The renaissance of expertise. Despite fears of AI replacing experts, we're actually seeing the opposite. Domain expertise is becoming more valuable, not less, but it's changing form. In the AI era, expertise isn't about memorizing facts. It's about having the mental models to know which facts matter. This explains why in the Berkeley Haas study of Kenyan entrepreneurs, those with strong business fundamentals thrive with AI assistance. Those that didn't fell behind. Another potential prediction, the great skill shift. We're witnessing a massive revaluation of skills in the workforce. Skills declining in value, rote information processing, basic content creation, predictable analysis. But skills that are soaring in value, strategic thinking, creative direction, critical evaluation, and human collaboration. AI is creating the first economy where how you think matters more than what you know. The motivation premium is the last of the three predictions. Perhaps most significantly, motivation and self-direction are becoming economic superpowers. Sam Altman, OpenAI CEO, recently observed the biggest productivity gap will be between the self-motivated and the externally motivated. This aligns with a pattern that we've observed across industries. Intrinsic motivation is becoming the key differentiator in AI-augmented work. When AI removes execution barriers, your internal drive becomes your greatest competitive advantage. This isn't just theory. We're seeing it play out in education too. A Khan Academy study showed that motivated students gained significantly from AI tutoring, while unmotivated students showed no improvement. So what's my practical advice for navigating this new landscape? Just learn to use AI. Learn to think with it. It's not about mastering the tools. It's about mastering the partnership. Here are three strategies I believe will help anyone thrive in this new environment. First thing, you've got to deliberately practice. You need to regularly solve problems without using AI to maintain core thinking skills. It's the age-old adage, if you don't use it, you lose it. So continue to leverage your core thinking skills. Secondly, strategic offloading, right? Being very strategic of what you offload. Consciously decide which tasks to delegate based on long-term skill goals. And lastly, partnership thinking. Frame your relationships with AI as collaboration, not just delegation. In the long run, yes, you will be delegating tasks, but think of this as an extension of you and you're collaborating with these tools. As we wrap up, let's remember that technology has always rewarded those who adapt most effectively. AI is just making this process more immediate and more dramatic. Whether the article we discussed, AI is coming for the unmotivated, proves entirely true, it remains to be seen. But what is clear is that AI is indeed amplifying the gap between different approaches to work and learning. In the AI era, your most valuable skill isn't technical expertise, your ability to direct your own growth and learning. Your challenge for this week, as you're using AI, as you're going through your day-to-day work, I'm not sure of what your focus area is. However, identify one area where you might be using AI as a crutch rather than a catalyst. Practice that skill manually, then return to your language model, the tool that you're using, image generation, you name it. Return to it with a stronger foundation. Also, definitely make sure you check out our sites below for additional training to learn about technology if you're looking to navigate and to transition into your career, whatever it may be. But focus in on what your skill set is and then return to leveraging these different tools with a stronger understanding of how to actually partner with them. Okay. Also, put down below in the comments, I want to hear about some of those weak areas that you've identified. And also if this episode has been helpful for you. All right. That's it for today's episode of Tech Innovation Made Human. As I just mentioned, if you found value in this, please hit like, subscribe, and share this with someone that's navigating their own AI journey. Until next time, I'm Jeremy McKellar, helping you make sense of technology's impact on our lives and making technology more human for you. Peace.